A viciously bashed prehistoric skull from China offers some of the earliest known evidence for violence between humans, but also suggests the ancient aggressors had a caring side. An ancient argument may have resulted in someone cracking the head of an ancient early human called the Maba Man. The discovery is based on CT scans of a 130,000-year-old human known as Mapa Man, also pronounced as Mapa Man, so named because his fossil remains were found near Mapa in Guangdong Province in 1958. The Mapa cranial vault fragment was discovered in 1958 during the collection of fertiliser at Shizishan Cave near Mapa Village in Guangdong Province. Most often allocated to archaic Homo sapiens, but some say this man belongs to Homo heidelbergensis, while others say he must be an intermediate between Homo erectus and Homo sapiens. The fossils consist of a skull cap and parts of the right upper face, including bones of the nose. As on Homo erectus, the brow ridges are pronounced, forming an arch over each eye, and the bones of the braincase are low and thick. Even so, the brain was apparently larger than that of Homo erectus, though precise measurement of cranial capacity is not possible as the skull's base is incomplete. Viewed laterally, the Mapa frontal has much greater curvature throughout its length than Zuccodian Homo erectus. Mapa was initially described by Wu and Pang in 1959 and is further discussed in Wu in 1988 and Wu and Poiria in 1995. The brow ridges are prominent with a curved outline but without pronounced thickening medially. In some respects, brow ridge shape is similar to European Neanderthals. Viewed superiorly, there is marked post-orbital constriction in combination with an inflated parietal region. Cranial vault bone thickness is similar to modern male East Asians and thinner than East Asian Homo erectus. Coming to the evidence of violence, the scans revealed a skull fracture caused by blunt force trauma. The skull has a small depression about half an inch long and circular in nature. On the other side of the bone from the indentation, the skull bulges inward into the brain cavity. Researchers from the University of Witwatersrand in South Africa said that the victim was probably clubbed with a weapon such as a stone, heavy bone, or lump of wood, and that this person had a pretty serious injury. They also said that the blow likely caused bleeding and a concussion, inducing nausea, vomiting, and perhaps even brain damage, leaving the victim prone and helpless. But the scans also showed that the wound eventually healed and that Mapa Man lived for years afterward, which means that the hurt man was likely cared for after his injury. Although accidental injury can't be ruled out, modern forensic science and other evidence points to foul play. Researchers who are not agreeing with accidental injuries say that it's hard to imagine how you would get just that one area of impact from, say, a fall. Another possibility is that Mapa Man might have had a run-in with an animal. A deer antler would be about the right size to make the forehead mark, though the researchers don't know if it would be forceful enough to crack Mapa's skull. Whatever the case may be though, the team also say that his recovery supports evidence from previous fossil studies that Neanderthals and other ancient humans, while often violently aggressive, also took care of their sick and vulnerable. Mapa's man convalescence would have taken days if not weeks, and he probably had to rest up and needed help with food and cooking. Mapa is housed in the Institute of Vertebrate Paleontology and Paleoanthropology, Beijing, China. And that is all, guys. What do you think of this? Let me know in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching and hope you enjoyed the content. For related videos, check our channel out and please do not forget to support us by liking our videos and subscribing to the channel. Till then, this is Halabella and see you soon in our next video.